Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how to filter your data in Microsoft Excel. We'll start right at the simplest way, and then we'll work up to the advanced filtering, and then I want to show you how to use a function to filter your data in Microsoft Excel. So let's get started with this today. There's a practice file down below in the description. You can follow along with me. If you're a beginner in Microsoft Excel, filtering is an easy thing to get started with. So here's the data that we're going to start with our basic filtering. I'm just going to click somewhere within this data that I have here. This is just a range, no table in here. Now I'm going to go up to the ribbon and make sure you're under the Home tab and then go over and find Sort and Filter. I'm just going to drop down on this and I'm going to click Filter. So if I go ahead and click this now, notice at the headers, I have these little drop downs here. This is where I can apply my filters. Let's say if I drop down on year, I can go at this point and pick a certain year. So if I say I want 2018, I'm going to go, the fast way would be to uncheck them all and then pick 2018. I could pick multiple years as well. So if I wanted 2012, I hit OK. Notice that it comes back as the two selections from those 2 years. I can go back at this time and decide, you know what, I want another year, hit OK. Now I have a few more. But since I've done the one filter, I can apply another filter on here too. Maybe I'm only interested in Studio 3 in that. So I can go through and pick a studio. So if I hit OK now, I can go ahead and I filtered it down to my year that I want and Studio 3. So you can really go through a lot of data using your filtering. Now, if I want to clear filters, I can just go back up to the top here and hit clear, and they're all back. So just a quick way to get rid of them. Now, let's move a step forward and go to an advanced filter. To use the advanced filter, I want you to go up to the Data tab here and take a look in the ribbon under Sort and Filter. Notice that we have the same options that I showed you under the Home tab or right-clicking. There's always a number of different ways you can get to these. I want to go to the Advanced here, but I want to do a little bit of stuff first. I actually want to go in this cell, and I'm going to type year, and I'm going to type in some years that I want to filter. So it's going to be, and this is kind of random, I'm going to say 2019, we're going to say 2015, and I'll just add one more here, and we'll go 2012, just like that. And you could pick any three that you want. I'm just going to click inside this information here. It could be in any cell. And then I'm going to go to the advanced. So there's right here. So I'm going to select it. Notice that since I was in it, and sometimes you don't have to be within it, and it will just find the data here. And so list range right here. And now criteria range is what I chose here, what I wrote. The thing is, though, you need to make sure that whatever the header that you place over here needs to match one of the headers over here. So you can see I have year here and year here, and I'm just going to go and hit the criteria range, and it's going to be right here, and hit enter, and I'm back to here. You could also go multiple columns. You just have to make sure that again, your header is going to match the range from something within here too. So I'm just going to hit OK. And now it's given me back those years. So 2015, I can see 2019 and a 2012. If you want to clear your filter, if you take a look up top, we can go up and just clear it and it puts it back. So I could go and enter some more information. So if I was turning this to a 21 here, then I could go back and do the same thing that I did before and go to advanced and choose it based on those. What I like next is I'm going to show you the function filter that can do, I find I like it how you can kind of dynamically change things from one cell reference. So on this spreadsheet, let's go ahead and set up the space we need to use this function, this filter function. And I'm going to go ahead and select just the headings here, and I'm just going to go Control C, and I'm going to go Control V, place them over here, and I'll just highlight all these columns and double click in between to set the width quickly that way. And I also want to filter by year again, so I'm going to type year here, and I'm just going to put a year that I want to filter by. I'm going to change this, but I'm going to just type 2019. Now I'm going to put the filter function right in this cell here.
And to do it, I could do the equals and start typing filter, but I'm going to go up to insert the function here. So insert function, and if you don't see it on your list, you can type filter, hit go. This is a Microsoft 365 subscription function, so if you're not seeing it, that could be why if you don't have that. So I'm just going to go ahead and select this filter. So what do I need? What's the array? Well, the array is going to be, and I don't want to include the headings, is going to be this area right here. So that's my array. What am I going to include? So this is the what I'm going to. So I'm going to click into the include. This is going to be where it's searching, like down here. So I'm highlighting everything in here. But I also have to add a step here. So I'm going to be adding the cell reference. So I'm going to put an equal sign in, and I could type the year 2019, but I want to be able to have it cell reference. So if I change that cell, then it will change automatically. So I'm just going to click on this right here and put it in. And then this last part here, if it's blank, I just wanted to return kind of blank. So I'm going to go and just put a couple of quotation marks there, and I'm going to hit okay. So, and I can adjust this more here. So you can see this one. And then I could do some formatting on these as well if I wanted to add the dollar signs. But take a look, 2019, so it's pulling from here. What I like about this method, if I was going to look for a different year, I could just type it in here, so 2022, and now it's bringing me back 2022. This way, you know, if you set any of these up here versus the way when we're just filtering, if you're looking, if you had a list of thousands and you had to go and deselect and select all the ones you want, where you can just go ahead and type it in here using the function. So just some tips about filtering, kind of from the simplest to the advanced filter to even using a function.